what we're seeing in Tahrir Square is the biggest demonstration, at least since the 11th of February 2011, when Hosni Mubarak stepped down. There are hundreds of thousands, if not more than a million people in the square and in the area around Tahrir Square. And now what they're chanting is Irhan, Irhan, which means to President Morsi, that means it's time to go.
Why are you here today?
Today, we have revolution.
Another revolution?
Yeah.
You had a revolution before.
Yeah,
why
yeah.
this revolution?
This is complete revolution.
And this revolution, say the people in Tahrir, is aimed at ousting the Muslim Brotherhood's President Mohamed Morsi after just 1 year in office.
It's only been a year.
We've gone downhill all the way in that year. But economically, security-wise, it's over. They've split Egypt in two, Islamists and non-Islamists, and we're all Muslims and we're all believers. Our conflict was a political conflict.
Military helicopters fly regularly over the square, cheered by the multitudes below, who view them as a sign of support for their protest. President Morsi, for his part, has said he is ready for dialogue, but it appears that the gap between the two camps is wide and only getting wider. There were demonstrations in support of the Egyptian president in another part of Cairo for the last several days, but they're much smaller than this one. The opposition has called upon its supporters to stay in the square until Morsi resigns, so some people clearly are ready to do exactly that. The demonstrations have so far been relatively peaceful, with most of the clashes taking place outside of Cairo. Some opponents of the Muslim Brotherhood have attacked their headquarters in a Cairo suburb. Police have refused to provide security, while gunfire comes from inside the building. Molotov cocktails go the other way. The end to Egypt's long-running revolution is nowhere in sight. Ben Wedeman, CNN, Cairo.